Hi, my name's Dan, and this video is one in a series that I'm doing about sound in the Unreal Engine. And in this one, I'm going to do just a kind of quick whistle-stop introduction to some of the more advanced features of sound. I wouldn't claim to be an expert in all these areas. I just want to point you towards where you might want to do further investigation if you want to get deeper into the sound stuff. Okay, so the setup I've got here is a standard third-person setup. I've imported one sound from a website called Freesounds, and it says it's an anvil being hit with a sledgehammer, and it sounds like this. And the reason for having that one is because I wanted a sound with no reverb on it so that we can have a look at reverb and how that affects things. The first thing I'm going to do then is I'm going to drag this sound asset into the level and make it play. And it's got auto activation on it, so it should be playing. And when we press play, it should play. There we go. Pretty straightforward. If we double click this asset, we need to make sure we're on the border of it, not on the bit that says play. You can actually open up a settings window. So there are things that can change in here. So the thing that I'm going to change in here, first of all, is looping. So I'm going to make it loop around so that it should go over and over again. Let's give that a go. Okay. And hit my mouse over there. Yes, I've put looping on, so that's just going to keep going forever, isn't it? We can change the pitch and the volume in here as well. So if I wanted to make that a higher pitch, just bring that up. There we go, and it's playing faster. What else have we got in here? We've got some subtitle stuff. We've got some loading behavior stuff. I'm not going to deal with subtitles. I don't want the analysis stuff. Envelope wouldn't work with this, but an envelope is to shape the sound. So if you've got a constant sound, you can make it more percussive at the start and tail off at the end if you want, using envelopes. And there's some effect stuff you can put in here. So again, I'm not going to explore effects, but here is the stuff where you can start plugging into effect systems in Unreal. To give you special effects, things like graphic equalization or phasing or things like that. And if you start to see things that talk about effects chains and submixes, that's the sort of thing. We could stick an attenuation in here if we wanted to, which should give us that attenuation, so it gets quieter as we get further away. I confess I've not tried this, so let's give this a go and see what happens. Let's create a new sound attenuation, and I'm not sure where that's been created. Probably here we go. We'll change that to natural sound. So this is just applying that in a different place. Yes, it does appear to work as expected, so that's good. And we go back into the sound settings. Well, that's the sound attenuation. This is the sound itself. So there's a whole lot of things that you can get access to there, including things like information about the sample rate and so on. What I want to do next then is look at audio volumes. So these are volumes in Unreal allow you to set up an invisible box where some kind of effect happens on something inside it. And when you've done blueprint scripting, hopefully you've done some of that, you've probably used collision boxes. They're a kind of volume. But we're going to use an audio volume here. And this is allows you to change the properties that affect sound within the area that the sound's in. So I'm just going to stretch that out, stretch that a bit higher, make that a bit wider. And the important thing that you need is you need the thing that's actually doing the hearing, effectively, is the camera in this case. So the effect of the sounds of this box will happen if the camera is inside the sound volume. We're going to apply some reverb, or certainly hope so. We've got apply reverb ticked. That's important. The reverb effect. Again, a reverb effect is an asset, so we're going to create a reverb. My reverb. And look at the settings here. This gives us kind of moderate reverb. I'm going to just pull up the late delay somewhat. Longer decay time, so that it'll sound like a larger area. So let's cross our fingers. Hope this is working. No, of course not. Right, so what have we done wrong? Let's go back into the sound. Oh, so that played with the reverb on it. So why isn't that working in here? Okay, I'm back. Apologies for that. So what I've done is I've taken off that attenuation that we put on before in the sound asset. So just set that to none. And now when we play. So here the camera's outside the audio volume. Here it's inside the volume, so you can hear the reverb is being applied while we're in the volume here. Okay. And then as I lift the camera up and out, we lose the reverb again. You've got to imagine where that box is. Okay. So that's audio volumes. They can be a bit tricky, as you've just seen. And it kind of relates to the attenuation sometimes, the problems that you might have. If you're trying to apply attenuation settings and reverb, and you're having a problem, it's not happening, there is another source of issues here, which leads me into talking about classes. So you can give all your sounds in your game, you can assign them to a class, which gives them some master settings that is applied to all of the different assets of that class. And in fact, the class itself is an asset. So when you attach this class, it applies these settings. And by default, there's a master class, which is attached here. So I've opened up the asset and I can double click on here. So I previously had problems with getting reverb to work because in the master class, this default 2D reverb was not set to 1. And that's the amount of the amount that it sends through to the reverb system. So you need to make sure that this is ticked and that this is set to 1. And as you can see, there are a few settings here. Some of them are to do with routing and stereo, and there's the submix for the reverb. You can also put other submix stuff in there as well. And you can derive from that and set other things. You can change pitch and volume in here. Low-pass filter. Let's see if we can quickly get this to apply. So a low-pass filter is it applies some tone filter to the sound, and low pass means it'll allow lower sounds through and not higher sounds. And this filter is set at the moment to 20,000 hertz, which is about the limit of human hearing at the top. So if we bring this down, we should be able to make it sound a lot muddier. Let's see if we can do that. So come down quite away from. This 1K is kind of middling. And let's just see what happens, see if that's actually made an effect. So as I hope you can hear, it depends on your system and how good quality your audio is, but that has taken the top edge of the sound off, and so it sounds a bit like you're hearing it through a curtain or something like that. And in fact, we've got the reverb on there, but the reverb is mostly in the high frequencies, so it's quite a bit harder to hear. So we've done a quick look at reverb, at audio volumes. We've had a look at the settings that you can have for a wave assets. We've had a look at the classes, particularly looking at the master class in here. I confess I don't know what this pin does and the other things that you can put in here, so you can have other classes feeding in, it looks like. I think the thing that I would say is, if you want more advanced stuff, obviously you need to go looking on your own and try and find out what you can do. Anyway, that's it from me for now.